on, fellas, we gotta go. That's too damn expensive to get a truck worked on.
That sure was.
I thought it was awful high, too. We'll get in the truck and let's go make some money. That sounds good to me. Alright, fellas, we gotta go. It's about damn time we got on the road again. I couldn't have stood one more day with that woman, that Peggy, I tell you what. I ain't even married yet, and she's talking my ears plumb off.
That's what you do, Ralph. That's what you do. I got you. If you want it, you're dead.
I'll be good, Duck. Be good, what the hell? Oh, yeah, Rusty. You ain't got no butter while we was off today. Was I supposed to, Rel? Nah, hell no. Nobody never expect that. This is a busy little city right here. I tell you what, I know. Like some of these vehicles that I'm seeing pass us and stuff. Yeah, I can't see much from back here, really, Russ. Do you have to try one of these days?
Can't see up drive, Ralph.
He's not crying, Duck. If you had to sit back there, you'd be crying all the time.
Yeah, I'm a wanker.
You a whiner?
Yeah, I'm a whiner. I don't know what the Exolite channel.
Now why would you go over the Exolite channel?
Yeah, I just don't know what's wrong with.
He probably wouldn't want to hang out with you.
And I won't talk to it, man.
Yeah, I'd say Tubbs would be the wobbly penguin. I'd say he'd hang out with you over at ACC, of course, a challenge. Group. I said, of course, a challenge.
I'm a little bitch.
That old geezer, he'd probably fry you up for dinner.
What?
Think you could take that, though. Nah, shut the hell up, you two, and let's go. Ralph, your job today is to do nothing but be quiet. Nah, that ain't gonna work, Rusty. That ain't gonna work out too damn hard. Too damn hard, Rusty. I said it's too damn hard. Hey, you got any trailers going out here? We need a trailer. Jack? There's the melt, folks. Going to get us a NASCAR trailer. We're going from Elko down somewhere down there. Had to read the map. I forgot. Where the hell did he go? I guess that Victor Radiator just sucks him right up. Nah, Rusty can't do that. Watch out. Don't run over him.
The robot, get ready. I need that question to help you get metal.
I hear you like my orange on my wheels, people. Hey, welcome, viewers, by the way. Truck a Duck Show. 389 Peterbilt by Viper. Skin for me by Alex for the boy. With the Truck and Duck Show skin. Pulling the trailer by I don't know who. Toyota number 56. NASCAR trailer. See that little window up there? That's their setting TV room and all that, where they go in there and have coffee and watch the race in there while they, while their car is smashed up in the pits there. Swifty, you know about that. You know, when your car gets smashed up, you got to take 30 minutes off and go in there and watch your reruns on the, well, the replays on the TV, how your car got smashed up. He had a couple bad accidents there lately. Wasn't his fault, people got in his way. Now that right, Rusty, you can't help it, somebody jump right out in the damn way. Oh, you can't only all be stuck. It's like that night I hit that deer, I was doing 55, 60. I got about 3 foot of hit or four, and it just leaped right out in front of me. My foot never had time to move from the gas pedal to the brakes. I hit it, the hood flew up a little on the side, one headlight went out. Had about 7, 8 more miles to go. So I never even stopped, I just kept going. And I drove over and that's a mistake though. I drove over and there's there's water and antifreeze and Freon shooting everywhere. So I had to leave it over and call somebody to come and get me and take me home. And then I got down there and estimated it about $6,000 worth of damage on it. 2008 Town and Country driver is about a new van. It had busted the radiator and the transmission cooler and the air conditioner thing on it. Lost all the Freon and everything. Good thing I didn't drive it much further.
Yeah,
I know you said it's tough when I hit it, but I didn't figure there's no use. I didn't figure there's nothing to save that deer. I didn't think it hurt the van. Yeah, the hood was bent, but what's that got to do with anything? And that's just another one of them things, of course. People watching, I'm glad to have every one of you here with us, taking a little ride with us. Back when I was working road construction on the drill, I was drilling the holes to blow up the mountain, so normally all the dynamite, blasting caps, and all that was right there with me. I've carried many, many cases of dynamite and blasting caps. Put them in the holes, start to let them down 50-foot holes, one come loose and fall all 50 feet, and all that stuff, fooling a lot of that stuff. But anyway, I'm going to tell you one little funny story there. I run a big old drill, I had a radiator as big as, as big as a 4x8 sheet of plywood, I guess the radiator was. And when you walk by it, it make your hair stand right up on the end because it was sucking dust through it from the drill and making static electric. Well, we had this powder man there, they call him a licensed dynamite powder anyway, but they call him powder man, but they had him there. He was almost bald-headed like Homer Simpson. Had about 3, 4, 5 hairs on top of his head. Maybe more than that. But anyway, he walked by there and his little hair shot up on top of his head. There went out classic. And he said, I'm going to see if this will set off a dynamite cap. So he got him 50-foot dynamite cap or 60, whatever it is, added a little more water to it and laid it over the bank where it wouldn't hurt nobody. He walked back up that old drill, stood by the radiator, and as funny as can be, he's rubbing that head, trying to get some static going. Them hair, them 3, 4, 5 hours just standing up there. Nothing ever did happen. Nothing. I figured it'd have went off too, but it didn't. Hey, you see what kind of view I got back here now, people? Do you see this? This is what I have to look at all day. It's pretty nice, though. I tell you, there's my microwave. There's my refrigerator. Up there's my Judge Judy. It's off right now. And I got a few more little goodies in here, out there, out the window. Over here is my closet where I keep all the duck stuff hid from him. Up there in the front, up there, over top of their head, that's the Rusty's and the duck's little closet. There's my radio. Hey, Ralph, none of that stuff's yours, that's my stuff. Now, you can't claim everything, Rusty. We gotta have something in here. We gotta have some space. I seen them one time, fat people. They was getting ready to set off a dynamite shot. I've been within, I'd say, 150 feet to 200 feet of hundreds of shots where they've blowed up a big part of a mountain. I've had to go in under the drill to keep rocks falling out of the sky from hitting me. And one time they was coming under the drill where they was bouncing that. I was a lot littler then. I went up between the rear ends of that thing to get up off the ground, and I had up between the rear ends on that thing. But I've had some close calls with rocks falling out of the sky. And I've had cracks open up under me where it cracked the ground right up under the drill, big crack run plumb under. But that dynamite is something else, and I've sat there and seen them blow up a mini mountain, and I forgot what I was going to tell you. That comes along with age, I think. I'll remember here in a minute, but I know it was working out there in the lightning storms with it all in the ground around you wasn't too much fun. I'd say it wasn't Rusty. I'd say it wasn't. It's a pretty comfy ride back here if old Rusty'd let me lay down. He don't go for that laying down on the job stuff, but really, really, what am I doing? Yeah, that's right, Ralph. Really, what are you doing and why am I paying you? Nah, hell, I don't know, Rusty. I don't know. Hey, you're just a good fella, Rusty. You're really a good fella. Yeah, I remember what they're going to tell you now. They're getting ready to put off a dynamite shot. When they do, they stop traffic everywhere with one of those air horns you can buy from like Walmart. Air horn. They blow that 3 times just for what they're going to shoot. Well, the powder man told the crew, his crew, about 2 fellas, but there's only 1 fella in the pickup, to take that pickup and get down off the hill and get down there and get out of the way and come back and get him when it's over. So the old fella starts down over the hill. Now the shot's right on top of the hill and he's driving down right beside the shot down in over that road cut off. The truck quits. He sits there and cranks it and cranks it and cranks it. Hears that old horn blast on that thing and he cranks and cranks. And he never did get it started. They put the shot off. Man, I'm coming through here like eggs to a funnel. I gotta quit talking, what's real. Anyway, they put the shot off. And all that mountain come out and hit that truck right in the side. Just shoved it over the bank, rolled it around. And that boy survived. It didn't hardly get hurt at all. And that truck was just squished up right in the middle like you see on TV when they run a car between 2 tractor trailers and they just squeeze them. It was in such a bad shape, they brought a, in a dump truck and just took a loader and lifted it up and threw it in the back of a dump truck. Didn't even bother hauling it with a wrecker or nothing. It was gone. I say that fella scared the rest of his life. But I saw that happen. I saw a lot of things. Yeah, you've been around a long time, you old gold Jeff. See a lot in that many moons. You were a door, Ralph. You always tired, Doug, and you don't do nothing. You might as well try some vitamin C, Doug. I seen on the news that that's the best stuff there was for you. Love Mama by Garth Brooks. Lyrics. Papa drove a truck nearly all of his life. You know he drove Mama crazy being a trucker's wife. The part you couldn't handle was being alone. I guess you needed more to hold than just a telephone. Papa called Mama each and every night just to ask her how she was and if the kids were all right. Mama would wait for the call to come in. When Daddy hang up, she was gone again. Mama was a lover, Lord, how she shined. Papa was a good one, but he's a jealous kind. Papa loved Mama, Mama loved men. Mama's in the graveyard and Papa's in the pen. Well, it was bound to happen. And one night it did. Papa come home and it was just us kids. He had a dozen roses and a bottle of wine. If he was looking to surprise us, he was doing fine. I heard him cry for Mama up and down the hall. Then I heard a bottle break against the bedroom wall. That old diesel engine made a eerie sound when Papa farted her up and he headed into town. Well, the pictures in the paper showed the scene real well. Papa's rig was buried in a local motel. The desk clerk said she saw it all real clear. Said he never hit the brakes, he just kept shifting gears. Mama was a looker, Lord, how she shined. Papa was a good one, but he was a jealous kind. Papa loved Mama, Mama loved men. Mama's in the graveyard and Papa's in the pen. Thought that was a pretty good drugging song. Even though I can't sing, but good lyrics. Garth Brooks lyrics or whoever wrote it. So we did that. Yeah, I could have done it better. Whatever, fellas, whatever, as always.
I want you.
What do you want, huh?
I just don't know why some people don't like me.
You don't know why some people don't like you. It's because you can't hardly talk, you're something.
What'd you say?
I said you can't hardly talk.
Yeah, but I just don't like to talk.
Well, I don't know about that.
Well, I just don't believe in the hood. I don't know what the hell's wrong with you, Trevor.
I don't know, Doug. I don't know.
Well, I work on it.
You gonna work on talking? Well, I don't know. I don't know if it's worth the effort or not. What do you think?
Well,
I figured that. I know the duck didn't give a damn. He ain't give a damn his whole life. That's why he got 9 kids and a wife and had to work all the time. That ain't nothing wrong to have 9 kids if you can afford them.
That's right.
People, I tell you what, I never preached to nobody or nothing, but I don't have no problem with myself, but if anybody ever offers you a pill or a drug or anything like that, don't never take the first one, people. Look all around, watch the news, look at the people, look at the zombies walking around. Check the people out that would steal the boat right out of your yard and sell it for aluminum, even though it was worth a lot, sell it for $150 to get some drug money. They all over my county. Everywhere. It's prescription drugs and being sold. And it's a terrible, terrible mess. They'd break in your house and kill you over that stuff now. It's awful. So when you take the first one and get hooked, you wouldn't think you'd never do it. Then the next thing happens, you're going along robbing people, try to get you some more. Something that you would have never, ever dreamed in your life that you would do. And that's the way it goes. So that's all I'll say about that. But just don't ever take the first one, people. And that's from old Rusty the truck. I know when I used to drink quite a bit on the weekends, just weekends. I was a social drinker. I never drank alone. I always just get together and drank a little. But I done things when I was drinking that I would have never, ever done on a sober day. And I could have been in jail. If somebody had asked me to do something crazy, like go help them run over somebody or something, I'd have probably been and said, hey, let's go. I see how a lot of people can get in prison that way. Then the next day, say, what the hell happened? Then it's too late. But don't let nothing take over your mind where your functions don't work right. And it will do it, all that stuff will. I know we have a terrible time here in this county with it. They call it this old hillbilly heroin, I think they call it, like that old prescription pill. They call it hillbilly heroin or something or other. It's a mess. It's ruined so many good people's lives. They look like they're starving to death. They run around. They ain't got no money. And if they do get money, it lasts about 2 days. Then they need to go steal some money. It's a rough life. Don't go down that track. Like Willie Nelson says in that song, that ship ain't right. That ship ain't right, boy. It's run too many people's lives. They ought to put the people that sells them in prison forever. Yeah, they messed up too many young people's life. Yeah, damn it, if I ever catch one of them, I'm gonna take him and wring his arm plumb off of him. He won't be able to reach out and get no damn money if I ever catch him. But there goes an old Buick or something. What the heck was that? Seen some nice old classics in here lately. Hey, like my camera angles on this video, people. It's definitely been different. But, there's your church, Ralph. We're gonna get you married, yeah? Yeah, she keep talking so damn much, I don't know if I want to marry her or not. Don't worry, Ralph. After 30 years, I quit talking at all. Did it take that long, does it, Rusty? Yeah, somewhere in there, Ralph. 25, 30. I'm in the doghouse now. Roll over, skinny dog, cause the fat dog's coming in. Stop that, Doug. Stop saying hello to people. People always let us know what you think down in the comments. I'll be down there talking to you. Cause so far, I've always talked to my viewers. If you comment, I'll talk to you. So if you want to say anything about the views, I mean, the way I'm doing the videos, come in down there and we'll talk. No, that's right, old Rusty. He gets in there and he answers them all. Yeah, I like to talk to him. I love to see comments so I can talk to him, joke around a little, kid around a little bit. That's what I like to do, joke around, try to make somebody laugh or something. I love that sunset right there. It's a great picture right there. They would put a sign up about right here, snakes crossing. It'd make people worry. Say, man, if a car breaks down here, we've had to lay snake crossing. Be a good sign to have beside the road. We got to take on a little petrol, people, and stop for the night. I kill that daggone engine every time because I hit the wrong splitter every time. I'm gonna have to buy that gear shift knob everybody's talking about, I reckon. Yeah, you need something, Rusty. You killed the engine more than anything. That Jeep I bought standard shift, people. My wife hadn't drove one in 20 years. And she got out in that Jeep the other day and took her a ride and done just fine. My daughter drove it, and I hadn't drove one in 5-6 years. Except this truck, and I got in it, and I didn't kill the motor net, no. But on this splitter thing keeps messing me up. I'm always in the wrong range. I don't know why. Hey, Trucker T. Hello out there. Now he makes good videos. Andrew T. Dregs. Old geezer. Crash Banger. Crash Banger, I think's his name. Make good racing videos. I got a lot of friends. I got a lot of good friends that stands up for me and be right there if I need them. A good thing to have. Come on, fellas, let's go get us some of them rotisserie hot dogs. Nah, boy, I've been wanting one of them.
Hey, what's up, fuzzy? What?
What are we waiting for?
I'm slow.
But don't be slow. Come on, Duck. Look at that sun, people. Have you on if it ain't starting to rain? Hey, people, thanks for watching the Truck, Duck, and Ralph show. Truck and Duck show. Thank you. We'll see you next time.